is Vreth from the Finnish black and folk metal band FINNTROLL, and you're listening to The Bloodshed with Vampire on Metal Messiah Radio International.
Vreth, it's a great pleasure to have you here on The Bloodshed with the Vampire on Metal Messiah Radio International.
Yeah, it's cool to be here again. I heard that we did an interview 7 years ago, 2013, right?
Yeah, so great to have you back. I think I just started at the radio. I can't remember who did an interview, but anyhow, it's so great to have you back on Metal Messiah Radio, Vreth.
Oh, it's really cool to be here again.
For those who don't know, FINNTROLL were conceived one drunken night in March 1997 with a heavy dose of beer and vodka, mixing a folkish melodic in the Humppa style of Finnish polka with heavy guitar seems a great idea to axeman Somnium, ex-Serpent, ex-Impaled Nazarene, and vocalist Katla.
Yeah.
When the duo was sober, the concept still kept its original appeal, and thus the mighty FINNTROLL came into being and have a career spanning over 2 decades, 6 full-length albums, 1 live album, and 2 EPs. The band's newest album, Vreth, was just released a couple weeks ago. How is the response from the underground media and fans to this album so far, Fred?
I've been really happy with the response so far. It's been really cool, and it's also nice to see that, you know, some of our older fans that liked what we were doing in the end of the 90s and the beginning of the 2000s, they are on board again and really liking this new sound that we are presenting on this album. It's really cool to that we actually made something that both the old school fans and also the new fans like as well. Feedback has been 99% positive so far, and I'm really blown away by it.
Very good. Like I was saying, one of the founding members, Somnium, fell off a bridge and tragically died, something that we still feel so sorry about. And the other founding member, Katla, is a part of Finno-Swedish minority in Finland, whose primary language is Swedish.
Yeah.
And almost all of FINNTROLL's lyrics was written in this native language and mainly deal with legends and tales revolving around the fictional troll king Refader and the trolls fighting against the Christians who entered their lands and spread their beliefs. Katla was forced to leave FINNTROLL due to a tumor and affected his vocal cords and could not be removed with surgery. Before departing, he started shared vocals with his successor Tapio at the time, Wiska, on the acoustic Visceral Slaughter EP. While Wiska departed following Nutfuck and Vreth, you became the new and still current band frontman. Yes, but in the meantime, Katla was writing of lyrics for all subsequent FINNTROLL albums. Vreth, how did you got on board replacing Tapio Wiska back in 2006? Was Katla still responsible in writing the lyrics for this new album?
Yeah, he was on this album, and he also made the 3 albums before me. Actually, the only album he hasn't written the lyrics for is for the Nutfed album. That is part Vilska and also our keyboard player Trollhorn that did a huge part of it. Katla has been writing from the beginning until this, except that one album. And I'm really happy for that.
So how did you get on board to become Wiska replacement?
I was actually back in 2005 and 2006. I was actually in school still, you know, I was studying, and I was actually in the same school as Katla at that point. And when the band fired Vilska, they actually called Katla up and asked him if he's got any there in the school, because it was an art school and it was lots of music involved. So they asked if he knows any singer there, and I was actually living in the same house as he at that point. So acquaintance here that actually lives in the same house as me, and shall I ask him if he wants to send some demos to you guys? And yeah, and here I am still 14 years later, I'm still a part of the band.
So when Katla asked you, you didn't think twice?
No, not really. Yeah, I think the same day, actually, I went to my record shelf and burned a couple of, 5 songs of my older bands and sent it to them, and yeah.
Okay, this current lineup has on keyboards and Mount Harp, we have Trollhorn, we have Tundra on bass, Skrymer on guitars, Routa on guitars, Vreth, you on vocals, Virta on keys, MörkÖ on drums.
Yeah.
I believe that you guys have a very solid lineup. And what's the reason do you believe that you guys are so very well connected to each other, Vreth?
Well, we have been doing this for a long time. Some of the guys have been in the band since we formed it in 23 years ago. So it's a long time. And even before that, Skrymer, Tundra and Routa, they were in the same school since they were kids and everything. So we are friends that make music together. I think that's a big reason why so many of the original members still are in the band and everything.
Besides being colleagues playing in the same band, I believe that you guys are good friends as well. Yeah. When you're not rehearsal, when you're not touring, I think you still have contact.
Yeah, definitely. Especially now when we, you know, we just released the album and we're doing promotion and everything. So there's day-on-day contact with everybody and there's lots of stuff happening right now. So we're also planning. We have had many of our music videos have been done by Routa, our guitar player. All the artwork is made by our guitar player Skrymer, and so everything is within the band. It's like a collective that works. Everybody's got their own part to do, so to speak.
Okay, talking about the band's last album, which was Blodsvept, the band's sixth full album, which was released March 2nd, 2013. And have represented a change from the usual black and folk style to the band to more industrial folk style. I mean, even though this album went a little into another direction, do you believe that the band got the response you guys wanted to with this album?
Yeah, that was sort of a continuation of the success we had with the Nephilim album. I think Blodsvept sort of kept us also going, you know, towards that direction. Even though in that particular time, folk metal was a little bit like oversaturated in Europe. It was too much like everybody had a folk metal band back then. I think, you know, with that album, we took a step away from the scene and we wanted to start exploiting more other genres, the metal scene, and especially like when choosing bands that we were touring with, we started to go away from, you know, the bands that always toured together. And it was, so yeah, it was a little bit of change in the direction for FINNTROLL, that album.
But it was well received by the fans?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, that was really good. And still, I can see now, a couple of albums later, that probably the biggest success was with the Nephilim album, of course. But that was also because the folk metal scene was so much bigger at that point. But that's probably the biggest album so far. Let's see when we actually can start touring on this Fredesvevd album, what is going to happen.
A year later, Vreth, on June 13, 2014, the band have released their first and still the only live album, Nathan Met Da Levande, FINNTROLL Live at Melkweg, Amsterdam 2008. How did you decide that you're going to choose that particular concert to become, as you know, the one to be on the live album?
Well, we've always been quite big in Holland. It's always been a good place to play for us. And that was not even on a tour. It was actually just booked because of Amsterdam. And we played all the time at Melkweg at that point. And when we decided to do an album, we just wanted to go back there because it's a great venue. It was the right choice because there's a lot of people there. It's too bad because we also filmed it. But yeah, it was so many problems with this material and everything that we couldn't use it. And we just ended up with using the music actually instead.
Okay.
A little bit sad, but yeah.
I must say that's a nice venue. I've been there too many times. Melkweg, beautiful place.
Yeah.
But my next question about this live album, it's only the Spike Farm era, right?
Yeah, but that was the last album we did on Spike Farm. Studio album was Yrjudens Djup in 2007, but this one also was recorded for Spike Farm, so they wanted to release it. So actually Nephilwind and Blodsvept, even though they are older, so to say, they are already released on Century Media that we are actually on right now. So yeah,
Vreth, back after 7 years of absence, Blackened, a folk metal pioneer, FINNTROLL, proved that they haven't lost a single step with an album chock full of folk inspired heaviness. Why have you guys waited so long to release a new album, and what was the band busy doing the last couple of years?
It took us 7 years. That's a little bit strange to say, because for the first 3 years of releasing the Blodsvept album, we were touring constantly. We were like, after this, we had been over 2 years on tour. We decided to do a continuation because we were asked to do like 10 year anniversary of the Notfed album that we released. That was 10 year anniversary going on. We decided to go on that, and we did that actually actually for 1.5 years. Mm-hmm. So then already we were 3.5 years into the whole next album cycle. And for some reason, when we started writing actively for this album, we couldn't really find the sound that we wanted. FINNTROLL always tries to incorporate something new on every album and something fresh that we have, like, but we couldn't find what we wanted to do, because the material we wrote, it was like 2-3 songs. They were totally different and we could never put them on the same album. So we decided to just take it easy, do a little bit more festivals and stuff, and then just make it come naturally. But actually, last year, 1 year ago, I was asked in some interview that when FINNTROLL is going to do a comeback. And I said, we never, you know, left the scene. I told the guys that we really need to work on the album. So we sort of focused everything and then we started writing. And last year, we actually found what we wanted for this album. And then in half a year, we wrote the whole album and reused some of the old stuff that we had written 3-4 years earlier as well.
Remember the first two albums released through the Finnish Spike Farm record?
Yeah.
The last three via German Century Media Record. And 7 years later, you return to Century Media Record to release Vreth's Fat. It has been a release already, September 18, 2020. After so long gap or breaks, is this a complete new contract that you guys have done now with Century Media Records? Or was this some kind of commitment that you didn't comply with throughout the years, the 7 years that you have to finish now? How is the story behind this new or already existing contract with Century Media Records?
I will actually not go into contract details here, because that's not what we're going to do. But yeah, we have been working with actually with Century Media already before we even signed with them, back when we were on Spike Farm at some points as well, distributed also in Europe with Century Media. So they were longtime friends. And last time when we were looking for a new contract after Spike Farm, Century Media, you know, it was the obvious choice because they had already distributed our 3 albums before. And it was a really good way to a continuation of how to release the album. Yeah, it was great working with them. So yeah.
Okay, talking about album, the new album will be available, yes, through Century Media Records. And you will be able to, yes, I believe, still get them in lilac LP version, silver, dark green, clear LPs, transparent red LPs, black LPs, standard CD jewel case, limited CD, media book and patches and slipcase, digital albums, all these kind of platforms. All these formats still available, Vreth, and the support of the label in promotion of the album. How are things going?
Well, I actually haven't got, because it's only been out for a week, so I actually have no idea, but I'm guessing that some of these colored vinyls are probably running out because they are very limited. I think the clear one was only made 100 copies. So that one, if it's not gone already, then you have to be fast, you know. And it's come to promotion. I've been talking for 4 weeks now with media almost every day. So yeah, I think we're doing pretty well on that front.
So you guys are getting a real good feedback in support of this great new album from Century Media?
Yeah, definitely. You can see the numbers are really clear when you see how much views everything have. You shouldn't stare yourself blind on the, you know, on the views. I think we're doing well.
Okay, to continue with this interview, the band's fifth full-length album, Yes, which was released last September 18, 2020. Vreth, what are the big changes compared to the band's last offering in 2013, Blodsvept?
Well, on the album before, Blodsvept, I think it was a little bit more, how to say, a riff-based album. There were lots of guitar riffs and a more mid-tempo album. On this album, we actually decided that we will go back in time a little bit, go back to the FINNTROLL roots and make a more melodic and more fast, a little bit more brutal album maybe than we have done for a long time. The big changes is really there, you know, the energy on this album is totally different. And when it's been 7 years since you released an album, it would be stupid to release an album that is slow and people would think, yeah, okay, those guys got old and boring or something like that. So we just decided that we tried to make as much like energetic, not like on purpose making fast songs just for the sake of making fast songs. No, it was with more energy in the album to show people that we are not aging and that we are here like 120%. We didn't fall asleep in between.
Fred, talking about the new album and all this energy it brings to you guys, has unleashed your first single, Orm Folk, that was on July 17. A couple weeks later, August 7th, an animated music video for Fortune, second single, and more recently, the third, I believe, the last single, Mask.
Yeah.
What would you like to share with us, with the audience, a little bit on how was the making of this video been and who were all responsible for doing this?
Well, Mask the video, it was sort of the story, you know, of the band waking up again. And in the end, you can see the people running out of their cave and into the world again. And it was sort of directly to sort of like what's going on in the band right now as well. I was a big part of this music video with the organization of it. Me and Skrymer were sort of behind the story, and actually had some friends from my hometown coming filming it, so it was actually a really cool cooperation. And I was a little bit scared in the beginning how it will turn out, and will it be too strange, and will it be you know, like a parody on the weird black metal again. But no, it sort of turned into some kind of small victory in the end, this music video.
To go to the last part of our interview, mix at the renowned Sonic Pump Studio, mastered by chart makers and produced by keyboard, yes, composed Henry Trollhorn, with you, vocalist Matthias Vreth Lilmans, acting as his right hand. How long was this process, yes, in making the music and the lyrics, and how was your experience in the studio this time?
Well, this is kind of weird, because usually in the studio, it's total chaos with FINNTROLL, you know. It's everything, every time we've been in the studio, something has happened, and something is going on, and we are late. And we are in a hurry, you know, to make up for time we have lost. And on this album, we actually sort of made it on time. We had the deadline and everything, and we actually made it. It was weird. I think it was on the day when we had the deadline to give it to the Century Media record label. It was on the day. But this time, we actually sort of made the whole album, you know, on time, and we were not losing in any tracks or anything. We didn't have to record stuff again, like it's been almost before. And really big thanks to Nino at Sonic Pump, because we have been working with him now for 4 albums.
The band has toured with bands like Epica, Flesh God, Apocalypse, Belphegor, Turisas, MMR, Behemoth, The Black Dahlia Murder, Battle Beast, appeared on festivals like Hellfest, Sweden Rock Fest, Tempere Metal Meeting, Wacken Open Air, Wacken Winter Night, Summer Breeze Open Air, Copenhagen Brutal Assault, Tuska Open Air, and so many, many great festivals around the world, but not to include, after doing North American and South American tour, not to forget their recent trip on the most famous metal cruise, the 70,000 tons of metal, just done last January 2020. How was it being on board of this luxury cruiser liner converted in a metal ghost ship for 4 days with 39 other bands and 400 wicked metal heads together with you, Fred?
Yeah, it's always been really fun to be part of this. We were there for the first cruise that happened 10 years ago, I think, and well, maybe more than 10 years ago, but yeah, we have been there for 3 times now. It's good fun all the time. It was a good way to end the gigging, because straight after the 70,000 tons of metal, the borders closed down, everything, coronavirus, the pandemic started, so it was a good way to have the last show, you know. It's good fun, and I like the good weather, so I'm enjoying every moment on it when I can be in the sun.
After eons of forging plans, writing new hymns and hidden from blacks, the trolls can finally announce that they are crawling out from their caves and into the tour bus again. March 2021, they will hit mainland Europe with their new album, Vreth, bringing old and new allies and to rate. Supporting acts will be Icelandic Skaldmold, returning from their hibernation, and Activista. Be preparing for all the troll heart shall be hitting your town very soon. Okay, Vreth, what are future plans for this coming 2021, where the band will be promoting this brand new album?
Yeah, that was supposed to be all over the world, but as it seems now, the world had other plans. So I hope that we can still do the European tour, and I think everybody out there is hoping as well. Yeah, next year we will be concentrating on Europe, like full on. We're gonna go everywhere we can go next year, and after that I hope we can open up some more borders and maybe go to America again, or South America, or maybe Asia again, or something like that. But you know, it's so uncertain right now. But there's over a month tour that is planned for March and April that's gonna go to big major countries in Europe, and that will be so much fun to be back in the tour bus again. It's been a long time. I've almost forgotten that part of my life in the last 3 years, you know.
Okay, Vreth, I want to thank you very much for having made this interview possible. I want to hand you over the microphone, a Mademoiselle Radio, for you to, yes, to invite all your friends and your fans to support the band, to buy the band's previous album, and to buy this brand new masterpiece, Vreth, which was released last September 18, 2020 via Century Media Records. Vreth, before I leave, my last question, how about merchandises? Do you have already t-shirts? You have patches? Do you have all this new logo, t-shirts, old hoodies, everything?
Yes, definitely. We have our trusted guy in Germany, where we also have our storage for all our gear, and he's got everything. Mr. Kapanen, check his pages out and get some cool shit.
Okay, Vreth, the microphone of Madame Messiah Radio, once again, it's all yours to thank whoever you want to thank.
Well, thank you, everyone. Thank you, Metal Messiah Radio, for this interview.
Vreth, I wish you all the best with this great new album. I wish you all the best with the band. I wish you all the best with all what you have coming for 2021 with the tools and promotion of this great new album. Say hello to all the guys from me. Say hello to Trollhorn, to Tundra, to Skrymer, to Routa, to Virta, and to MörkÖ for me, and to all the whole crew of FINNTROLL. It's been a great honor once again. And you guys, take care. I hope to see you guys on the road in Europe or here in North or South America. Gonna keep in touch. Take care.
Let's do so.
Bye-bye. Like always, metal on. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.